Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pravanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Vrindavan, and we're hearing how he went to Goloka Vrindavan and he met Lord Krishna.
我们一直在讲述Gopakumar的历程，他是高尔丹山的一个牧牛童，他旅行到了Vrindavan，在那里他遇见了Krishna。Goloka Vrindavan。他旅行到了Goloka Vrindavan。Means
Vrindavan in the spiritual world.
也就是在灵性世界的Vrindavan。So
he met Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna went home to Mother Yashoda, and Mother Yashoda and the gopis, they arranged for Krishna's bath, and then they dressed him in nice clothes and ornaments.
And Krishna
enjoys taking service from the gopis. They were even putting ointment on Krishna's eyes to make them shine. And as they were serving him in this way, Krishna would speak to them about what happened in the forest and how they played games with the cowherd boys. The gopis, although they were decorating Krishna, they were never able to complete the decoration. They would say, no, it's not good enough, we'll have to do it again. There were many distractions in the middle of their decoration. They were putting tilak on Krishna and painting his hands and doing all these different things. So there were many distractions because Krishna would be playing, would be joking with them and having fun with them.
Krishna呢一直在跟他们玩耍，给他们开玩笑，然后呢，所以就不断的就打扰他们。
The gopis wouldn't feel satisfied. They say, no, this is not right. We have to do it again, and they rub it off and do it again.
Gopis们呢对此就很不满意，然后他们说不行，我们得再次重来，所以他们就把他 这种图案给涂掉，然后就再次重新绘。
And Mother Yashoda would get anxious about her son, that why did it take so long, and Mother Yashoda would come and speak to the gopis as if she was almost as if she was angry.
Yashoda 妈妈就感到有些焦虑了，对她儿子感到很担心，为什么他们花了这么长时间？然后Yashoda 妈妈就过来跟gopi们讲话。
She wasn't actually angry, but you know, it appeared like she was angry a little bit.
老师的妈妈呢，就显得有一点生气，但实际上呢，她并不是真的心里生气，只是外表上显得有点生气。
Because she knows how much these gopis, she knows all these young girls, the gopis, she knows they have so much love for Krishna and they're genuinely trying to serve Krishna.
他知道这些年轻的勾品们，他们是多么的喜爱他的儿子，真正的真心实意的在服务他的儿子。
Mother Yashoda would speak to the gopis and say, "Oh, you're just children. We can't depend on you."
有时候妈妈对这些勾品们就说，你们还是孩子呢，我们不能完全依赖你们。
Mother Yashoda knew these.Girls from their birth, and so she's very familiar with them.
Yashoda's 妈妈从这些年轻姑娘们从她们小时候出生就认识她们。
And she would say, "Why haven't you finished bathing and decorating Krishna yet? You're taking so long."
Yashoda's 妈妈就说，为什么你们还没有完成给 Krishna？穿装打扮的过程为什么要花这么久呢？
Such a simple thing you have to do, but you're taking so long.
这件事做起来很简单，为什么你们要花这么久的时间呢？
So the gopis would stand around Krishna and they'd be looking at him and they would all be...worrying, maybe we haven't done our service right.
这些勾品们就站在 Krishna 四周，就都看着，注视着 Krishna， 然后就担心着，是不是我们没有做，我们做错事了，没有把事情做对呢？
So there was one elderly lady there, and she noticed Krishna.And she understood Krishna's mood, that Krishna is joking, that he likes to have jokes. So she said something.
有一位年纪比较大一点的勾皮木牛女就注意到了 Krishna 是处在一个开玩笑的心态当中。然后她就开始跟他说话。
So the lady said, this elderly lady, she said, oh, my daughter Yashoda.Come and see. You will be happy to see this. These gopis, these girls, they've made your dark blue son, they've made him very handsome.
蓝皮肤的儿子把他打扮得那么英俊。
So Yashoda would come out, and when she understood the joke, she spoke out as if she was angry. She pretended to be angry.
而亚修的妈妈就出来了，就出来就开始说话，就表面上好像有一点生气。
And she said, "Don't you know all kinds of beauty?Worship the lotus feet of my Shamsundar."
难道你们不知道各种各样的美学道理吗？该怎么崇拜Krishna 的莲花足？
My Krishna, my Shamsundar, he dances on the head of the universe.
我的 Shamsundar。在宇宙的头顶 上在跳舞。
There may be many good-looking boys or young men in the world, but none of them can equal the son of Mother Yashoda.
也许有很多很多，就相貌英俊、年轻美丽的男孩子，但是他们都没法跟亚修达的儿子媲美。
So his name is Shama Sundar. Shama means the dark blue color, but Sundar means very beautiful.
所以他的名字叫 Shama Sundar. Shama 的意思是深蓝色， Sundar 的意思是非常美丽。
So his complexion, his dark complexion, makes his beauty very special.
因此他的深蓝的肤色就使他显得是异常的美丽。
Now these young girls, they have some beauty, but not even their beauty, their beauty doesn't equal even the tip of one of the toenails of my Krishna.
这些年轻的女孩子们，她们也许是非常的美丽，但是她们的美丽甚至都没办法跟我的 Krishna 的一个脚趾头的脚趾尖的美丽媲美。
Right, because people may say, well, okay, Yashoda's son is very beautiful, but Radharani and her gopis.They're also very beautiful.
人们可能会说，好吧，亚修的儿子是非常的相貌英俊的，可是 Radharani 和那些高品牧牛姑娘们也是，她们的美丽也是超绝非凡的。
But Yashoda said no. Actually, these girls, their beauty cannot equal the beauty of my son.
但是亚修的妈妈说，不，这些女孩子的美丽没办法跟我的儿子比美。
Whatever little beauty these gopis have is of no use because they are not meant to become his wives.
这些姑娘们的一点点美貌都没有用，因为呢，她们都不会成为 Krishna 的妻子。
So Gop Kumar is there, and Gop Kumar is asking, is it possible to describe Krishna's beauty?
So Gop Kumar is there, and he asks, is it possible to describe Krishna's
beauty? The special sweetness which is there in Krishna and his effulgent form.
Krishna 身上特殊的甜美之处，以及 Krishna 他的形体发出的光彩。
There's nothing in the world which can compare to the sweetness of Krishna.
在这个世界上，没有什么能跟 Krishna 的甜美相比。
Not even Krishna as the Lord of Dwarka or Krishna's any other forms can ever equal the sweetness of Krishna.In Vrindavan.
甚至 Krishna 在 Dwarka 的形象，还有 Krishna 的其他的形象，都没办法跟在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 的甜美相比。
So Krishna's beauty is so amazing. Everything is perfect about his bodily features.
所以 Krishna 的美丽是那么令人惊讶，他的身体的一切的特征都是完美无瑕的。
If we try to compare the beauty of his eyes or any of his features to anything in the material world, it's a failure.
把他的眼睛还有他的身体的 身体的特征要和这个物质世界的一样事物相比来比喻的话，那都是一个失败。
Sometimes we say, oh, Krishna's beauty is like the lotus, but it doesn't really give full justice to the beauty of Krishna.
有的时候人们说 Krishna 的美就好像莲花一样，但是这种比喻也不能也这种比喻是对 Krishna 的美丽来说也是不恰当的。
And if we try to compare the features of Lord Vishnu or any of the other incarnations to Krishna, they cannot equal the beauty of Krishna.
如果要把 Krishna 的美丽和主 Vishnu 或者 Krishna 其他化身的特征来相比，那么他们都没办法与 Krishna 的美丽 与他并驾齐驱。
Even if you look at Lord Narayan, or the Lord of Ayodhya, Lord Rama, or Krishna in Dwarka, they're not equal to Krishna here in Vrindavan.
如果人们看一下主 Narayan 呢，或者是 Ayodhya 的 Rama, 或者是 Dwarka 的 Krishna, 都不能和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 媲美。
So Krishna is the best of all the romantic heroes, and Radha is the most, she's the best of all heroines.
Krishna 是所有的，是所有的众，是有着浪漫情怀的那个男英雄当中的佼佼者，而 Radharani 呢，是最好的，是最优秀的女英雄。
So actually, the only beauty that compared with Krishna's is the beauty of Srimati Radharani.
事实上，唯一的能和 Krishna 的美丽相比较的是 Srimati Radharani 的美丽。
So when the gopis saw that Nanda had taken Lord Nanda Maharaj, the father of Krishna, he's the king of all the cowherds, that he'd taken his bath and he had arrived there with Balaram, then all the gopis disappeared and Krishna came forward.
当所有的 gopis们看见 Nanda Maharaj, 也就是 Krishna 的父亲，他也是所有牧牛郎的国王，看见 Nanda Maharaj 沐浴完之后和 Balarama 一起过来，然后所有的 gopi 们立刻就消失了，然后这时候 Krishna 就走了过来。
So the gopis, they could recognize Nanda Maharaj's voice, so they realized, oh, Krishna's father's coming, oh, and Balaram's coming, Krishna's older brother, so they all disappeared, they just went hid themselves.
狗皮们都能认出南达玛拉的声音，他们意识到哦 ，Krishna 的父亲过来了，他们也意识到了 Krishna 的哥哥 Balarama 也来了，所以他们就消失的无影无踪，把自己给躲了起来。
So Nanda Maharaj sat down in the seat in the dining hall to have his meal, and two boys on each side, Krishna and Balaram, they also sat with him. They also ate.
南达玛哈日就坐在饭厅，在饭厅里坐，就坐，然后他的两身旁各坐着 Krishna 和 Balarama。Krishna Balarama 也坐在南达玛哈日的两身，身侧，一边一个坐下来开始进餐。
So Krishna sat on the left of Nanda Maharaj, and Balaram sat on his right, and Gop Kumar was also brought there, and he was told he had to sit opposite to Krishna and Balaram.
在 Nanda Maharaj 的左侧， 坐着 Krishna， 南大大军的右侧坐着 Balarama， Gopal Kumar 也被带了过来。他被告知，被告知要坐在 Krishna 和 Balarama 的对面。
So this is etiquette. Etiquette is the oldest son should sit on his father's right side. And then the youngest son is on the left. So Nanda Maharaj can feed the youngest son. He can give food to Krishna with his own hand.
照理礼节，就是长子要坐在父亲的右手，而小儿子是坐在父亲的左手。这样呢，父亲就可以用亲手给小儿子给 Krishna 喂饭。
So Nanda Maharaj would share his food with his two sons, and Gop Kumar he had his separate food.
Nanda Maharaj 就和他的两个儿子分享了食物，Gopal Kumar 有他单独的食物。
And Krishna and Balaram are still young boys at this point. They didn't have the sacred thread. They didn't have the Brahmin initiation. The sacred thread ceremony hadn't been performed yet. So they were still young children. So it was all right for Nanda Maharaj to give them food.
Krishna and Balaram, they were still young children. They hadn't been performed yet.所以他们的父亲就给他们喂饭，这是无可厚非的。
Then, from inside the house, Mother Rohini is there. Mother Rohini, mother of Balaram, she's there, and she's been arranging the food, and she puts the food into many different special vessels, which are some of gold and silver and have many jewels, and she would arrange to send the food in to Nanda Maharaj and Krishna and Balaram.
In the house, there is Rohini, Krishna and Balaram's mother. She is arranging the food for them. She puts the food in different kinds of jars, from gold, silver, and jewels, and jewels are made of gold.就让这些食物呢，给端到南达玛拉这个 Krishna Balarama 的面前。
And the food which was brought in, there were four kinds, you know, four kinds, just like we saying food which is licked and chewed and swallowed and sucked. Food of all different qualities were brought in and offered to Nanda Maharaj and his two sons.
有四种食物，一种是舔的、咀嚼的、可饮的、吸住的，这些不同种类的食物就被端了进来，端给南达玛哈拉什还有他的两个儿子。
And the food had very nice smell, beautiful aroma, it was colorful, it was very tasty.
这些食物都散发着迷人的芬芳。而且是五颜六色、五彩缤纷的，品尝起来都是味美多汁的。
And everything was arranged very artistically. It was very well. It was served from beautiful dishes. And it all looked very appetizing, very something everybody would want to eat.
这些食物呢，都被摆放的非常精美，放在这个盘子里，看上去赏心悦目，而且呢，他们都令人胃口大开。
And Gop Kumar would watch carefully to see how Krishna would eat, and Krishna would take pieces and he would make small balls and he would chew and swallow.
Gopal Kumar 呢就注意 Krishna 是怎么吃的。Krishna 呢会把这些食物 把这些食物呢给搓成一个小球，然后呢就放在嘴里，咀嚼完了吞咽下去。
So the many different delicacies were brought in, in beautiful bowls and containers, and it's all put on large golden plates.
各式各样的，就是准备精美的食物都放在精致的小盘子里，或者是小碗里，然后放在一个很大的金盘子上面。
And sometimes Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda and sometimes Balaram, they would each take turns to put food into Krishna's mouth and Krishna would accept it.
Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda, 还有 Balarama, 他们轮流的就把食物放在 Krishna 的口中，而 Krishna 都愉快地接受了。
And sometimes Krishna would also drink. In the course of taking the food, he would also enjoy to have some drinks. And the liquids which he drank were in big bowls.
Krishna, 在进餐的过程当中呢，还不时不时的喝饮着一些液体。
And there was a big container of fresh water.
他是用一个大杯子喝水，然后还旁边还有一杯新鲜的清水。
And so at the beginning of the meal, Krishna took some sweet rice mixed with ghee and sugar, which was very tasty.
一开始 ，Krishna 首先吃了一些甜奶饭。这甜奶饭是用纯净的酥油还有冰糖做成的，是非常的美味。
Then there were also cakes and pies and jalebis and breads.
还有各式各样的蛋糕、糕点，还有酱，还有面包。
可能 jalebis， 可能你不知道 jalebi。
不知道。
If you have a sore throat, jalebis are very good for a sore throat.
如果是嗓子疼 ，maybe I can check.
It's an Indian sweet. It's very sweet, and it's kind of, you know, you have to fry it, and then it's coated in sugar. It's very, very sweet.But very delicious also. In the cold weather, it's very good to take jalebi.
This 食物叫 jalebi， 它是一个印地语的词。它的做法是先把它炸了，炸了以后呢，裹上一层，外面裹上一层糖，然后这个它对嗓子疼非常好处，而在寒冷的天气里吃是非常好吃的。
And Krishna would eat other things fried in ghee, and he also had sweet yogurt.
Krishna 也吃了其他的，就是用纯净酥油来炸好的食品，还有甜的酸奶。
And there were other things with yogurt and milk mixed together to make different preparations.
另外一种呢是用酸奶、牛奶混合在一起，然后做成的其他的另外一种食物。
And then in the middle of the meal, he would eat fine white rice, which was very warm and fragrant and tender.
然后在中间的时候，他吃了一些精致的白米饭。这个白米饭是热的，是很柔软。
And then he would take bowls of fried. There were fried dal. You know dal, dolly.
Yeah. Yes.
So fried. There would be bowls of dal fried.
炸豆汤，还有一杯炸豆汤一碗。
And there were different green leafy vegetables and soups and vegetable dishes.
还有绿叶蔬菜汤。
And then there were many different preparations made with milk, and mostly sweet and some sour in taste.
以及用牛奶做的，有味道是甜的或者酸的牛奶的制品，但是非常好吃。
And some sour things were mixed with salt and different.
以及加了香料的食物，比如说加就是用红辣椒做的，或者是用小茴香籽做成的这种香料的食物。
Then towards the end of the meal, he would eat some more sweet yogurt.
那么在快吃，进餐快结束的时候，他又吃了一些非常甜的酸奶。
And he would take some buttermilk. You know buttermilk? Buttermilk. Buttermilk, it's a... Buttermilk, when you take the fat off the milk, you're left with buttermilk. And it's a milk product.
假设你把这个就是牛奶它上面的这层脂肪去掉的话，那剩下的这个就叫buttermilk，就是脱脂牛奶。
And they would add some hing, asafoetida in that as well, and different spices to give it taste.
有些食物是用hing这种香料烹制成的，或者是用其他的香料烹制的。
So Krishna would eat this, and he, sometimes he would also come and give Gop Kumar, feed Gop Kumar. So there's a recipe given also how to make this yogurt preparation. That if you have some yogurt, you add cinnamon, and then you add some rock sugar. You know, bintang?
Yes. Uh-huh. 另外一种食物是，就是酸奶里的再加了
cinnamon.
Yes. 加桂粉和就是粗制的冰糖和桂粉做的酸奶制品。
Cinnamon is 肉桂呀。
肉桂，cinnamon.
And then ground black pepper.
还有黑胡椒，棕色的黑胡椒。
And ground some green cardamom.
绿色的一些棕绿色的卡达门。
And then honey and ghee also.
还有蜂蜜酥油。
And you have to keep the mixture, you have to keep it in some ice to cool it, make it nice and cool.
还有加上一些冰，里面放一些冰块，让使它变得很冰凉爽，冰爽。
Then in the hot weather, it's very delicious to taste this.
在炎炎的夏季，能吃到这种冰爽的食物是非常可口的。
So it's difficult to describe all the things which Krishna would enjoy tasting. And Krishna's beautiful tongue would rise to his upper lip while he chewed, tasting all these delicacies.
Krishna, 美丽的舌头，还有他的美丽的这个唇舌呢，都会在那里品尝着这些精美的食物。
Just watching Krishna eat the different foodstuffs is so wonderful, it's so beautiful to see Krishna eating the food.
就仅仅是。 在那里观赏 Krishna 进餐时他的这些动作举动，他的动作就是那么令人赏心悦目。
Everything Krishna does is so attractive and so captivates the mind of his devotees. And the gopis, the pure devotees who are surrendered to Krishna, they are also very attractive. Everything they do is very attractive. So the gopis went to their homes and they brought many sweets from their homes, sweets cooked in milk and ghee and sugar, and they brought them and gave them to Mother Yashoda that she could give them to Krishna. And Krishna would playfully, with great pleasure, Krishna would sit and taste each of these different dishes and relish them. And he would take even more than one piece from each plate, and this way he'd make the gopis very happy. And he would feed Gop Kumar. He'd come and feed Gop Kumar with his own hands. He'd say, "Taste this, this is really good, have some of this," and he'd feed Gop Kumar. Then Radhika, Sri Radhika, she brought very special ladus. Some were small, round ones, and some were large, flat ones. And she put them down on Krishna's left side.
Radhika 过来了，她带了一些特殊的拉肚。
These ladus are called Manohara ladu, which means that it steals the heart, the ladu that steals away the heart. So you just taste this ladu and you're completely defeated. It tastes so delicious, unbelievable. So Krishna picked up some of these sweets with the nails of his thumb, and put a little piece on the tip of his tongue, and then he made a face just like it was something very bitter. So everybody was watching, everybody in the house was watching, and Balarama, he smiles, he sees Krishna pulling the face, bitter. So Balarama just smiled. But Mother Yashoda, she was angry at Radhika, that what have you given my son? Nanda Maharaj, he was surprised. He thought, what's happening? What was this?
Nanda Maharaj 就惊讶了, 这是什么? 发生了什么? 这是什么?
And Radharani and all of her friends, they're very pained, they're worried that what happened? Why is it like this? Why is he screwing up his face? What went wrong? And the other gopis who are competitors with Radharani, because there's two camps. There's the right-wing gopis and the left-wing gopis. So Radharani, she has people in her team, but there's people who are not in her team. So the people who were not in her team, they were very happy when they saw that Krishna was not liking this sweet made by Radharani. But some of the gopis, they were more clever, and they know that this is a joke, that Krishna is just playing a joke. So Gopkumar says that, he said, I was born in the family of Radharani's brother. Oh, this is Balaram. So Krishna said, I was born in the family of Radharani's brother. Or Balaram said, I was born in the family of Radharani's brother.
Balaram said, I was born in the family of Radharani's brother.
Yeah.
Oh, Balaram said, 我出生在 Radharani.
And Krishna threw all the ladus onto my plate.
Krishna 把所有的拉肚扔到我的盘子里了。
So I was surprised to find them very good. So I ate them all.
我很惊讶，发现他们都那么好吃，所以我全吃光了。
So Sridham is the brother of Radharani.
Sridham is Radharani's brother.
And Gopkumar, he is also a member of that family.
Gopkumar is also
a member of that family. So Krishna put all the ladus onto the plate, onto his plate.
Krishna put all the ladus onto his plate.
And these ladus, the bitter ladus, Krishna was saying, these bitter ladus are no good for me, they're not fit for me.
Krishna said, these bitter ladus are not good for me.
Let Radharani's relatives eat them.
Let Radharani's relatives
eat them. Actually, Krishna knew the ladus were very perfectly prepared, but he just wanted to give them to Gopkumar out of his love. So Radharani secretly looks at Krishna and she arches her eyebrows, you know, like she's a little angry.
Radharani 就偷偷地看着 Krishna, 然后他的
But Krishna wants to make sure Radharani was not ashamed or unhappy. Mother Yashoda was angry at her because Mother Yashoda thought she'd done something wrong. But Krishna wants Radharani to know that everything's okay. So Krishna smiles at her and he encourages her by giving her a nice glancing at her in a loving way. So Gopkumar understood this was all a pastime which Krishna was performing, just to give more love, to increase the love of his devotees. By these kind of pastimes, the devotees get more, their love for Krishna increases. And so Krishna has finished taking his food, he washes his mouth with warm water, and then he takes some pan to chew. And then after he chewed it a little bit, he put the pan into Gopkumar's mouth. So in this way, Krishna gives pleasure to Radharani because he was giving the remnants of his pan, he was giving it to a member of Radharani's family. Gopkumar remembers from Radharani's family. So Mother Yashoda is always concerned about Krishna's health and she wants to keep him healthy. So she chanted some mantras and rubbed his belly with her left hand.
亚修的妈妈就很关注Krishna的健康，然后她就唱了一些曼陀罗，又用左手来为Krishna的肚子按摩。Because
she wants to make sure Krishna will digest everything she has eaten.
她要确保Krishna把所有吃的食物都消化掉。Actually,
everything which had been given to Krishna was very nicely prepared, and it's not going to cause any indigestion. But Mother Yashoda is always concerned to keep Krishna comfortable and make him happy. That's her special love for Krishna. So Nanda Maharaj, after taking his meal, he goes out into the cow pastures, and Balaram, he went to sleep.
Nanda Maharaj 进餐完之后就去了牧场，而巴拉拉玛呢，进餐完之后就去睡觉了。
And Krishna, he starts wandering around the village, around the village, and he's singing songs wherever he goes.
Krishna 呢就开始在村子四处游荡，而且他一边走着，无论他去了哪里，他都在唱着歌。
Mother Yashoda, she was busy inside doing housework, and so Krishna is able to enjoy more private pastimes.
Yashoda 妈妈在屋子里正忙着家务事儿， Krishna 这时候就可以享受更多的私密的消时光。
When Krishna has his private pastimes, then Balarama is not there.
每当 Krishna 享受私密的消时光的时候， Balarama 都不在场。
So Krishna is eager to enjoy with the beautiful girls of Vrindavan.
Krishna 渴望享受 Vrindavan 的美丽女孩子。
And played it for a short time. He enjoys outside joking words with the gopis.
他就这样在外面玩耍，跟勾皮们开着玩笑。
But then he can hear Mother Yashoda calling him. So he goes home and goes straight to his bedroom and lay down to take rest.
Krishna 听见亚修的妈妈叫他回家，他就回到自己的卧室。
So Krishna is eager to enjoy with the gopis, but he's also attracted by the special love of his mother.
Krishna 虽然渴望享受 gopi, 但是也被他母亲的爱深深吸引。
Krishna enjoys all different relationships, not only just Madhurya Ras with the gopis. He also enjoys his relationships with his mother and with the other cowherd boys.
Krishna 享受各种各样的关系，不仅仅是 Madhurya Ras 与 Gopi 的 Madhurya Ras 情侣之爱，还享受跟他母亲以及他那些牧牛郎之间的关系。
So Krishna's bed has very nice soft pillows and beautiful.Sheets, everything is very perfect, very clean.
Krishna 的床榻非常柔软的，他的枕头也都是非常柔软的，他的床单非常干净，一切都是那么完美。
And the bed which is on is also decorated. There's different jewels and ornaments on it.
Krishna 躺着的床也装点着各式各样的珠宝和小饰品。
And some of the pillows in Nanda Maharaj's house, they're like the full moon in shape and in color.
在 Nanda Maharaj 家中的一些枕头的形象就像皎洁的圆月，无论是它的形状还是它的这颜色都像皎洁的圆月。
But different from the moon, because on the moon there are spots, but on these pillows there's no spots.
但是和月亮还不一样，因为在月亮上还有斑点，而这些枕头是没有斑点的。
And the pillows are also very soft, especially the one he uses to rest his head.
而且这些枕头全都是非常柔软的，特别是那个 Krishna 枕着头的枕头。
And there's a canopy over the bed with different strings of pearls decorating it.
在 Krishna 的床榻的上方是一个罩子，就像类似于枝形的灯枝形的吊灯那样的一个圆的吊顶，然后四周呢垂着一串一串的珍珠。
And the room had a beautiful aroma. They were burning some aguru incense to make a nice aroma everywhere.
Krishna 的房 房间里就弥漫着阿库鲁香的芳香。
So the canopy was helping to put a shade over Krishna. Sometimes at night the moon is very bright, so by having the canopy over the top, then it allows Krishna to get shade from all the light.
Krishna 在床上面，吊着的这个伞形的罩子呢，就在。有着皎洁月光的夜晚呢，就被 Krishna 的睡眠就遮挡了皎洁的月光。
So Radharani, she made some pan, and she wrapped the pan into packets, and she offers them to Krishna, putting one of them in his mouth.
你知道他让你做了一些，准备了一些槟榔，然后就把它们打包。给 Krishna, 他就把一颗槟榔放在 Krishna 的口中。
And the gopis Chandravali and Lalita, they massage Krishna's lotus feet.
Chandravali 还有 Lalita, gopi 就为 Krishna 莲花足按摩。
So there's different services to be done for Krishna, so they allocated the different services to different gopis.Somebody would use the yak tail to find Krishna.
有不同的服务给 Krishna 做，有一些 Krishna 就把给他们分配不同的服务。有些是用犀牛尾做的浮尘，为 Krishna 扇凉。
And then another person would hold the box of pan, so that if Krishna wanted more pan, he could take pan.
另一个牧牛姑娘手中呢，就捧着一盒槟榔。倘若 Krishna 想要吃更多的槟榔，她就给 Krishna 献上一个。
Then there was somebody else holding a container because after Krishna chewed the pan, then he will take it out. He will give the remnants. So somebody is there to catch the remnants of Krishna's pan.
还有另外一个gopi呢，就手里捧着另外。一个容器，因为 Krishna 他咀嚼完槟榔，会从口中拿出来，然后把这咀嚼过的槟榔呢，就放在另一个 gopi 们手中的这容器里。
And then there's big pots of fresh water also.
还有一罐新鲜的清水。
And other gopis were singing songs and reciting prayers that pleased Krishna.
还有其他的 gopi 们在那里唱歌，或者是吟诵着祷文，取悦 Krishna。
And some of them could play different musical instruments.
有一些 gopi 们擅长弹奏乐器。
And some of them were there just to make joking words with Krishna.
还有一些在跟 Krishna 开着玩笑。
So Krishna takes pleasure in hearing all these.Gopis perform these different activities.
Krishna 听到这些 gopi 们从事的各种各样的活动，感到非常高兴。
So Krishna is seeing all these gopis serve him in all these different ways. Krishna would give the remnants of his pan.To
the different gopis. Krishna 对这不同的 gopi 们的服务方法都感到很满意。
Krishna is not so eager to take their service, but he wants to fulfill the desires of these gopis.
Krishna 并不渴望去接受这些 gopi 的服务，他只是为了满足 gopi 的愿望。
So on this occasion, he gave the remnants of his pan to all the gopis, but doesn't mean that he treats all the gopis exactly the same.
在这一次 ，Krishna 把他咀嚼剩下的槟榔送给 gopi 们，但是在其他的时候，他会做别的事情。
Now, he will reciprocate with the different gopis in different ways. They're all individuals. So he was able to please all of these different gopis by his behavior. And then Krishna would be able to take a short rest. And Krishna, of course, he takes special pleasure in talking to Srimati Radharani.
Krishna 会和 Radharani 从与 Radharani的谈话当中得到特殊的快乐。
Okay, so we will stop here.
好，那我们讲课部分就停到这里。
Are there any questions today?
No, Chip. Yes. 第一个是 Shruti Rupa, 领拜guru和老师们, 在Krishna知觉的学习中, 我应该如何快速从有冒犯的念诵, 有期待的服务, 提升到消除冒犯的念诵, 和无欲无求的纯粹服务呢? So, Shruti Rupa, Manaji has two questions. Obeisance to Guru and teachers. During the course of Krishna consciousness, how can I quickly rise from the platform of offensive chanting and service with expectation to chanting without offense and pure devotional service without any desire?
Well, you have to avoid the offenses. You have to know what the offenses are and you take care to avoid them.
你要避免冒犯，你要知道。
The main offense is distraction. You don't chant with attention. So you have to chant very carefully with full attention, full concentration. So you should chant clearly and carefully every morning. And you can pray to Lord Balaram to be merciful to you, to help you to get rid of your faults in chanting.
您可以向主巴拉拉玛祈祷，祈求他的仁慈，去除您在唱诵过程当中的错误。
You can do more chanting to improve your quality in chanting. You do more chanting.
为了增加 改善念诵的品质，可以做更多的念诵，念诵的圈数多。
Yes.
The second part of questions, 有一个正在参加门徒课程学习的佛法出家人。 现在越来越依赖Krishna知觉，但是目前他的状态暂时不能离开佛法团体，请Guru送给他祝福和建议，让他更好的保护，提升自己Krishna知觉，感恩Guru。So the second part of question is that there is a guest, the monk or the nun, a Buddhist nun who is participating in the course of a disciple course. And she became more and more dependent on Krishna consciousness. But right now, she cannot leave the Buddhist group. So I want Guru to send her blessing and advice so that she can protect her Krishna consciousness and elevate herself. Send gratitude to Guru.
Okay, yes, blessings. So we bless her that she can become a devotee. She doesn't need to leave her group. She can stay in her group and also be Krishna conscious. 好的，我们给他祝福，他可以做奉献者，他不需要离开他的团体，他可以留在那里，然后去有Krishna之觉。Yeah, we have some nice devotees who are Buddhist monks and nuns, and they chant Hare Krishna.
我们有一些很好的优秀的奉献者，他们是佛教的和尚，原来是和尚或者尼姑，他们现在在唱诵着 Hare Krishna.
So, you can remain in your Buddhist group, just chant Hare Krishna.
您可以留在自己的佛教团体，一直念诵 Hare Krishna.
Read the Bhagavad Gita.
他要阅读《博家梵歌》。
So we bless your Buddhist monk, your Buddhist friend, that they can also become Krishna conscious.
我们祝福您的佛教朋友，他们可以成为拥有 Krishna 之觉。
Just remind them that the goal of Krishna consciousness is to be the servant of Krishna, not to become Krishna.
只是需要提醒他们 Krishna 之觉的目标是成为 Krishna 的仆人，不是自己成为 Krishna.
In Buddhism, often people want to become the Buddha, but in Krishna consciousness, we cannot become Krishna. We're only trying to be the servant of Krishna.
在佛教里，他们是目标是成佛，但是在 Krishna 之觉中的目标不是成为 Krishna， 而是成为 Krishna 的仆人。
Okay.
Okay. The next question from Yona. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. At what level of devotional service a devotee can understand whether he will go to the spiritual world or be born again? Thank you very much. 下一个是来自 Yuna 的 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 请接受我卑微的礼拜，在哪奉献福的哪一个层面上，一个奉献者就能明白他将会回到灵魂世界或者再次投生呢？感谢您。
Well, we have to be free of all material desires. We just want to have Krishna consciousness, then we can go to the spiritual world. Yeah, we have to develop love for Krishna. When you love Krishna very much, then you want to go to be with him.
如果是特别爱 Krishna 的，就想去和他在一起了。So
we have to give up all of our attachments to the mundane things, to the material things.
我们要放弃对那些世俗的物质事物的依附。We
should understand everything is Krishna, since all meant for his service.
我们要明白一切 都属于 Krishna， 都是要用来为他做服务的。So
if you have that consciousness, then you can go to the spiritual world.
如果您拥有这样的知觉，就可以去灵性世界了。Okay，
下一个问题。
Varshana Sundari Devadasi, Hare Krishna, 深深顶拜 Guru Maharaj 莲花祖， 感恩主持人的甜美服务。 请问 Guru， 有个新奉献者朋友说， 他看到他身边有的奉献者修习 Krishna， 奉爱瑜伽，坚持念诵仍然很痛苦， 所以他对 Krishna 信心不坚定，所以迟迟没有拿起念珠念诵。这样的新人朋友该怎么给他一些帮助呢？让他坚定信心呢？ Hare Krishna obeys a pay deeply obeisance to Guru Maharaj's lotus feet. Thank you for the host and translator. And my question is that there's a new devotee friend. He said that after seeing some devotee while practicing bhakti yoga and chanting, but still felt very painful in the heart. Therefore, he has no faith in Krishna, no firm faith. Therefore, are reluctant to take up the japa beads to chant. So to this kind of new devotee, how can I help him and strengthen his faith?
Well, I don't know what happened, why he has pain in the heart. Who are these devotees who have pain in the heart, who are chanting Hare Krishna? You have to understand, pain in the heart, it may be due to the love of Krishna. It may not be material pain, it may be spiritual pain. Due to their great love of Krishna, they're feeling pain in the heart.
我不知道为什么这一些奉献者他们一边唱诵阿尔奎什内心还很痛苦，可也许他们是因为爱奎什呢才痛苦的，这种痛苦不是物质的痛苦，而是灵性的，出于灵性的爱，他们是因为爱所以才内心痛苦。
Sometimes people cannot understand the mood of the pure devotees. That what may appear to be pain in the heart, it may be the ecstasy of love of Krishna.
表面上的显得是痛苦，也许是因为对 Krishna， 由于对 Krishna 狂喜的爱造成的。
But anyway, this person, whoever you're talking to, they should be willing to accept the japa beads and to start chanting. Until they do that, then they're not committed, they're not serious about Krishna consciousness.
无论如何，您说到的这位新朋友，他应该是愿意拿起念珠来念诵的，否则的话，他对于 Krishna 拒绝就不是认真，就不是认真的。
So if this person's not going to chant, then he's not a good candidate for devotional service.
如果这个人不念诵，就不是做奉献服务的合适的候选人。
So be careful about association.
所以要小心你的联谊对象。
You have to find people who are genuinely interested in Krishna consciousness. And that means they'll chant.
你必须找那些对 Krishna 知觉非常认真的人，这样的认真的人意味着他们是会念诵的。The next question.
Yes.
It's from沈阳的 Bhakti 鱼领拜 Guru， 感恩您。我在家不做肉菜，我吃素，爱人吃他自己做的，但有时候需要照顾父亲和爱人，热下剩菜给他们吃尽职责。在不得已做这些时，怎么能做冒犯罪恶最少呢？ So this devotee pay obeisance to you. And she said that although she herself do not eat meat, but and her husband cook his meal, but sometimes she has to take care of her old father and husband and have to warm the remnants of the food, maybe those non-vegetarian food has to reheat them. So she asked how can she avoid offenses and reduce her sin in doing this? because she is doing her family duties.
Yes. So, and you should feel very sorry in your heart. You should pray to Krishna that because you have some very bad karma, you're in that situation.
你要在内心感到很难过，要向Krishna祈祷，因为过往的不良的业报使您处在这样的困境当中。
So you have to do these kind of duties which are not good for your Krishna consciousness.
所以您不得不做这些对您的Krishna知觉不利的职责。
And so you have to beg Krishna to try to forgive you.
您要祈求 Krishna 尽量的宽恕您。
You have to tell Krishna that I'm sorry, I'm in this situation, I have to serve my husband, I have to serve my father. Anyway, I'm willing to go to hell, but please don't let, if I have to go to hell, please don't let me forget your service and service to your lotus feet and to chant your holy name. That even if I go to hell, let me remember to chant your holy name.
我非常抱歉，因为我不得不服我的丈夫和父亲，所以要去地狱。但如果我要去地狱的话，请让我不要忘记服务您的莲花族，不要忘记唱诵圣名，即便在地狱当中，也能够唱诵圣名。 The next question is, Jaya Govinda Devadasi, 顶拜Guru。 请问您，在我的记忆里，吃槟榔有点上头的感觉。如果醉酒的状态，我总觉得它是麻醉品之类的食物。请问我们可以使用槟榔吗？谢谢。 Obeisance Guru, in my memory, the pan, if one eats pan, will be some disease in the head, like some toxicated. I feel that it's kind of a drug. So can we also eat pan? Thank you.
No, we don't eat pan. Krishna eats pan, but we don't eat it.
不，我们不吃槟榔. Krishna 吃槟榔，我们不吃.
Sometimes the temples they will offer pan to Krishna. But they will not eat it. They will give it to people who are not devotees to eat.
有的时候，有的庙宇会给 Krishna 供奉槟榔，但是他们自己不吃，他们把它给非奉献者吃。
下一个问题。下一个是这个
Vivo Y93，顶拜感恩Guru，孩子以前是主动。 主动念诵，现在是我催促看手机游戏直播时念诵，这样会和主链接上吗 ？Krishna Das 喜欢您 Guru， 能否训示点什么要注意的呢？我真的没有力量帮助他。 So this mother devotee she pays visits to you and her child previously is volunteer to chant but now is under the urge of the mother while playing the cell phone games and at the same time chanting. So is this kind of, can my child connect with the Lord? By this way, my child Krishna does love you, Guru. Can you give him some instruction and to, what should my son pay attention to because I don't have my power to help him.
Well, if he's playing with the handphone and chanting, his chanting is not good.
如果他一边看手机一边念诵，他的念诵就不好。
Cannot do two things at one time.
不能两，就是一心二用。
So his chanting, you should say, if he wants to play with handphone, first of all, he has to chant. And then after he's finished chanting, then you can give the handphone.
如果他想要玩手机游戏，你要告诉他，等你念诵完，你再玩游戏。这样等他念诵完之后，你再把手机给他。
You have to separate the two.
你必须，让他不要这两件事同时做，不要念诵，旁边还放着手机，分开。
Yes.
The next one is from Sun Zihan. 顶拜 Guru 念诵时做别的是不是冒犯呢？有一些奉献者买类似肉的方便食品，用豆腐做成了鱼、火腿，这个允许吗？ So Sun Zihan pay obeisance to you, and this devotee said that if we while chanting we are at the same time doing other things, is this a kind of offense? And the other part, this is the first part of the question.
Yes.
是的。念诵做别的是冒犯。
Sometimes you may have to do it, but you must try to do at least 16 rounds without doing other things. After you finish your 16 rounds, then you can chant and do other things. But first you do 16 rounds without doing other things.
有的时候呢，就是在做事儿，有必须有，就是有些事情我们是必须去做的，但是至少你的16圈是不应该一心二用的。你要完成你16圈的时候是应该一心一意的做的。然后在你念完16圈之后，你其他的时候可以一边念诵一边做别的事儿。
下一个问题。
下一个是next part is that some devotees buy food like that of, the taste is like meat, but it's made from tofu, like the vegetarian fish, vegetarian
chicken.
Those kind of things.
Yeah.
Is this allowed?
Well, yeah, it's allowed, it's tolerated. It's not the best thing, but you know, you can do it. Some people find difficult to cook vegetarian, they don't know how to cook, so they get these things, vegetarian meat, vegetarian fish, and they eat this.But it's not very nice to offer to the deity in the temples. We try not to use this.
这是允许的，但是就是是被容忍的，但不是最好的，是可以的。因为有的人他做素食很难，他不会做，所以他们就买些素鱼啊、素火腿啊、素肉啊吃。这不是好的做法，不，通常是不会供奉给神像的，在庙宇里是不会供奉这类食物的。
嗯哼。
The next question is from Kamalamurti. No, 还是 still 孙子涵。顶拜咕噜，请教咕噜，我看到瓦坛中说妻子要不修。蝙蝠防止丈夫欲望，又看到了奉献者打扮的花枝招展，取悦Krishna，到底应该怎样才是呢？So this devotee pay obeisance to you, and she asked. This devotee asked, in the Bhagavatam, it said that the wife the wife should not should be careless, should not pay too much attention to the clothes, so that to not agitate her husband. But at the same time, I saw some women devotees, they decorate themselves very nicely to please Krishna. So what's the right way?
Yes, they can decorate themselves to please Krishna. That's very nice.
花枝招展来取悦Krishna，这很好。
So, decorate yourself to please Krishna. It's done in a different, you know. Nowadays, people they think they can attract their husband by wearing clothes which reveal their body more. You know, they want to have mini skirt or topless, and you know, things which expose the body, but in the Vedic culture, for the pleasure of Krishna, the body is covered.
如果您把自己打扮得很美来取悦Krishna，这是可以的。但是现在的人们是穿着很暴露、很性感来吸引丈夫，穿着迷你裙。但是在伟大文化当中，为了取悦Krishna，女性呢，她们会把自己裹。
So it's important, body should be covered, not exposed, not naked.
所以，很重要的一点就是，女性的身体应该是，就是不要暴露。 自己的身体要用衣服给遮掩起来。
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the wife has to please the husband. She should dress for the pleasure of the husband. I think there's nothing wrong in that.
妻子取悦就是穿的。 把自己穿着打扮的来取悦丈夫，这一点是没有错，没有什么，是无可厚非的。And
at the same time, she should also please Krishna.
与此同时，妻子也应该去取悦 Krishna. Next question. Vivo. Y93，Guru， 我嗓子疼的时候念诵会就好了，这是主给我的仁慈的展示吗
？Yes。So
this， 是的。
Krishna chanting Hare Krishna is a real medicine for the throat。
唱诵 Hare Krishna 是治嗓子的真正的药物。
So keep chanting。
所以要继续念诵。不断的念。哦，要不，sorry。所以要不断的念诵。嗯。连下一个问题。下一个问题来自于 Radha Nanda Devadasi， Hare Krishna， 深深顶拜敬爱的 Guru Maharaja。 请问，遗忘了 Krishna 的灵魂，主 Krishna 依然仁慈地赐予他们想要的，但为什么还要把他们不想要的生老病死给他们呢？无限的感恩念。So Hare Krishna obeys deeply, dear Guru Maharaj. Those souls who have forgotten Krishna. And Lord Krishna still mercifully bestowed them whatever they want. But why Do Krishna still give old age, disease, and death those things they don't want? Give them.
Well, Krishna will only give it, that those things are only there in this life because we took birth, so we have to give up this body. But this can be the last birth. We don't have to take birth again. And with old age and disease, a devotee becomes more serious about Krishna consciousness. And death is simply giving up the body so that we can go back to be with Krishna. Shall I go into?
Oh, sorry, maybe because she mentioned that those souls who have forgotten Krishna, those souls and Krishna give whatever they want, but at the same time also give them those births, that old age and disease and death for those souls.
Oh, for those souls who have forgotten Krishna.
Yes.
Oh, for those souls who have forgotten Krishna, they will stay in the material world. And so in the material world, the laws of the material nature are there. And the law of nature is that there's birth and death. They've forgotten Krishna, they just want to enjoy the material world, so they can enjoy it, but they can only enjoy it according to the material nature, that it's material nature, so it's temporary. So they cannot enjoy forever. They want to enjoy forever, but they cannot do that. Krishna won't, it's not possible in the material world. So material world is to take away, that they should become frustrated in trying to enjoy in the material world. And they should realize they've made the mistake trying to enjoy the material world. They should want to go to the spiritual world. But if they want to go to spiritual world, they have to develop their love for Krishna. Material world, they're just in love with their body. They're in love with the temporary body. They're not going to get, they're always going to be disappointed in their attempts to enjoy in this material world.
In
So Krishna gives them what they want, but he only gives it temporarily. He doesn't give them forever.
So Krishna 虽然给了他们想要的，但只是暂时的给了他们想要的。这些呢是不能永久的在那里。他给他们的这些事物呢，不是永久的。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Sati David Dasi. 顶拜 Gurudeva， 请问启迪之前做奉献服务需要发大愿吗？ 需要发大愿吗？ 我们伟大经典有如何发愿的资料和实例或经验吗？ 请乌德给我仁慈，给我训示。中国的佛教资料和事例中有发愿修行圆满的故事，拍成电影、写成书。有的法师居士也宣讲。This is maybe Sati asked the question on behalf of others. So, Sita. Sita, she pay obeisance to Gurudeva. She asked, before initiation, should one make a big vow to do devotional service? In our Vedic literature, are there any instance or experience of this making big vow?
Well, at the time of initiation, we make a vow. Make a vow. You mean?
Because in Buddhism, some da yuan, some people they would make a big plan to fulfill something.
Okay. Well, that's up to the individual. That's nothing, there's no rule about this. Generally, a devotee is cautious not to make any big vows in front of the deities. Not in front of the deities, anyway, we don't make a vow.
无论如何，我们不会在神像面前发，就是发这种宏伟的誓言。
But it's up to every individual. You want to do something, you have some goal, you have some ambition, you want to do a particular activity, you want to please somebody, then you can do that. But that's not devotion. We're talking about devotional service. Our vow should be in relation to Krishna, to the service of Krishna.
就我们的誓言是跟 Krishna 有关系的誓言。
Just like we make a vow, we may make a vow that I'm going to chant so many rounds.
比如说我们发那个一个宏大的誓愿是，就是念很多的圈数。
Or you make a vow, I'm going to go to visit the holy places.
或者是发愿要去圣地拜访圣地朝圣。
So you can make a vow like that for the devotion of God.
可以发这样的愿。
But it's not required, it's up to every individual.
但这不是必须的，这是取决于个人。
You like to make a vow, you can do it.
如果你想发这个宏大的誓，宏大的这个愿望的话，你可以去做。The next question is, 沈阳 Bhakti 鱼，顶拜咕噜，听您讲小 Krishna 吃饭的场景特别甜美，心都融化了。可我自己没有耐心，没有兴趣做饭，怎么办呢 ，Hare Krishna？ She obeys the guru. I felt very sweet while listening to you talking about how Krishna enjoy eating, but I myself don't have patience, I don't have any interest to go cook. So what should I do, Hare Krishna?
You don't eat? She doesn't eat anything?
那关键就是，如你自己难道不吃饭吗？
She likes to eat, you eat other people's food. What other people cook, you eat.
是不是您是就是别人做好了，然后您就享受现成的呢？
You have to eat something.
你肯定必须得吃东西吧。
Even you don't eat yourself.You should understand cooking for Krishna is a way of service to Krishna.
不管怎么说，您要明白，为 Krishna 做饭可是一项为 Krishna 的服务啊。
And Krishna likes to taste the devotion. So somebody who has devotion, they will enjoy cooking for Krishna.
奉爱，所以一个有奉爱的人，他会享受、喜欢去为 Krishna 来做饭。The next. Yes. Radha Nanda, they does make a comments, but 非常感恩亲爱的所有的服务者。顶拜下一个是 Harivansa Prabhu 的顶拜咕噜，请问咕噜，经典里提倡为某人灵性进步、身体健康祈祷和祝福，某人就会灵性进步或身体健康吗？如果这样的话，只需要让圣人祝福我们灵性进步就好了。还是更重要的是聆听经典，让某人觉悟自我呢。So Harivansa Prabhu pay obeisance to you. He asked that in scripture it is advocated that for the spiritual progress of somebody or for somebody's health.We can pray and give him blessing. Somebody will make a spiritual progress and will be healthy. And he further comments that if it is the case that we only ask the sadhus to bless us to make progress, or is it more important for us to listen to scripture and
Yes, it's more important. Let somebody read scriptures and realize himself.
是的，就是您后面说的那个更重要，就是让他去读，聆听经典，去觉悟自我，这个更重要。
At the same time, we can also give blessing.
但是同时，我们也还是可以给他祝福的。
You need both.
就是这两件事是都需要的。
If you just have one, you just have blessings, but he doesn't read the scripture, then it's not going to work.
如果仅仅是一个光是有祝福，然后自己也不去读经典，那就不起作用了。
So you need the blessings, and you need to have also the individual effort.
所以，就是一方面我们是需要祝福的，一方面人是需要祝福的，另一方面人他自己也要去努力才好。
嗯哼。下一个问题。
下一个 ，Sita Devadasi， 顶拜 Gurudeva， 如果发愿可有可无，为什么好多婆罗门启迪的奉献者告诉我要发愿呢 ？Sita Devadasi further， this question is related to the love. Above question about making the big vow, big wish. If there's no necessary to make big vow, why some devotee who have undergone second initiation told me I have to make big wish, big vow?
I said it's up to the individual.
公说了，我刚才说过，这都是个人的事情，是自己的事情。
If you want to make a big vow, you can, but it's not compulsory.
如果一个人他想要去发大愿，可以去发大愿，但这个不是强制性的。
I would like to know what vow they made. What was the vow?
那我想知道他们到底发了什么大愿，这大愿的内容是什么。
Second initiation, the vow, strictly follow four principles, chant 16 rounds. And the same vows we take when we make first initiation.
想得到第二次启迪，他要发誓严守四项规范原则，念诵十六圈，跟他要得到第一次启迪的时候要发的愿是发的誓言是一样的。
下一个问题。
下一个是。美玲，顶拜 Gurudev， 请问怎样能得到圣人祝福？什么情况下圣人愿意给祝福？美玲马大姐 ，Obeisance Gurudev， how can I get blessing from a sadhu? Under what circumstances those sadhus?Are willing to give their blessings.
What blessing do you want?
那问题是您想要什么样的祝福？
You want to have just happiness in material life? You just want to have happiness? You just want to have money? You just want to enjoy sense gratification? You want that kind of blessing? Sadhus won't give that blessing.
您想要物质快乐吗？您想不想要金钱呢？您想不想要感官享乐呢？ 人是不会给予这样的祝福的。
You want blessing to become Krishna conscious? Yes, okay, we can give that blessing.
您想要得到就是拥有 Krishna 知觉的祝福吗？如果是这样的，是可以的 ，okay 的，是可以得到这样的祝福的。
But you have to be worthy to get blessings. You have to be qualified to get blessings from the sadhu.
但是，您必须得有资格配得到这样的，圣人，配得到圣从圣人那里得到这样的祝福，
sadhu, 需要资格。Sadhu may bless you, that your material life will all stop, will all be.Finished, will all fall apart.
圣人们可能祝福你，你的物质生活结束了，你的物质的生命就是已经解体了。
Then you will be very worried. Oh, I won't have any sense gratification.
然后，如果您真的得到这样的祝福，就会开始担心了。哦，我没有感官享乐了。
How will you live? How?
怎么生活呀
？Krishna says that when I'm very merciful to someone, I take everything away from them.
Krishna 说，如果我对一个人仁慈的话。会把他的一切都拿走。
And then when they're very helpless, and then they turn to Krishna.
当他们处在这种无助的状况下的时候，就会转向 Krishna 求助了。
When you're in difficulty, then you chant the holy name better.
一旦你处在困境下，您的念诵就会特别的有感情。
But when you have your material comforts, I have my nice apartment, I have my nice husband, I have my nice family life, I'm happy, you won't chant so well.
但是如果你有一个很好的物质生活，很舒适的公寓，有自己的丈夫，有一个很好的丈夫，家庭生活，就这样的情况下你的念诵就不会很有品质的。
So if you're attached to material situations, you will not make progress in spiritual life.
如果依附物质的处境，就不能在灵性生活当中取得进步。
So you should be careful. You ask a blessing from the sadhu may give the blessing you didn't want.
如果您想要得到萨杜的祝福的话，可要小心了，因为这时候您得到的祝福可能是不是你心里想要的祝福。
还有问题吗？
还有。
还有多少？
孙兵，还有 only one.
Okay.Okay, go ahead.
Two, okay. 下一个是孙兵，顶拜咕噜，感谢你。我的问题是，有人经常能听到内在声音告诉他如何，他认为是 Krishna 在告诉他。我一直疑惑，到底是 Krishna 告诉的，还是内在的另一个灵魂？这个灵魂是好的，在告诉他呢？每次他都能收到信息，顶拜咕噜的莲花组。So, obeisance to Guru, so my question is that somebody always can hear an inner voice telling her how to do things. She always thinks it is Krishna is directing her, but I'm doubtful whether it is Krishna or another soul.This is a good soul, directing her, and each time she receive the message.
So she has to consult Sadhu and Shastra and Guru and see if what is coming from her heart is actually proper. We don't just take instruction from the heart, you have to confirm with the spiritual authority. So we bless her. We bless her to have more service. Well, a devotee is always compassionate to others. He feels compassion for the fallen conditioned souls and he always thinks for the welfare of others. But being compassionate for them is to help them in a spiritual manner, not just simply material. We want to bring them into Krishna consciousness. So that is, anybody who is in a devotee in Krishna consciousness, they're committed to giving Krishna consciousness to others. And giving Krishna consciousness is the highest welfare work. It's the greatest benefit for all mankind. You have to know how to help people. If we just simply feed them, that helps them one day, doesn't help them the next day.
提供食物，那只能帮助他们一天，第二天就帮不到，不给食物就帮不了了。
But if you give them knowledge of the soul and Krishna and devotional service, that's eternal benefit.
但是如果给予他们灵性有关于灵魂的知识，奉献服务的知识，这是对于他们是永久的好处，永久的福祉。
So we're committed to that kind of welfare activity.
我们，所以我们承诺的是这种的福利工作。
We make a vow like that to distribute Krishna consciousness, distribute the holy name of Krishna and teach people about Krishna. That's what we do. That's our vow.
我们发的大愿是派发 Krishna 之觉，派发圣灵，要教导别人有关于 Krishna， 这是我们的宏大的誓愿。
Okay, we will stop here today.
好，那今天早上我们就到这里了。
感谢 Guru Mani 给我们今天的翻译，感谢 Sati Juja， 感谢所有的奉献者聆听。祝福你们唱诵并快乐，今天的卡德西多念诵，多看书。
Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki.